they aren't necessarily the drugs of choice. Experts say they're just easy to get addicted to. Morphine, Oxycontin, Vicodin, heroin, opium, the list goes on, and so do the problems.
Visits to the emergency department for opioid overdose have tripled just since 2010.
There are about 3,000 opioid-related ER visits every year in Wisconsin, according to the Wisconsin Hospital Association. While these patients aren't clogging up hospitals, they're often treated first in the emergency room, and their treatments get more intensive as the addiction goes on. Intense treatments mean intense bills. The Office of Economic Advisors says just one opioid-related hospital visit can cost as much as $100,000. Many opioid abusers can't afford their visits to the emergency room, and who picks up the tab? Well, we do. That can often lead to higher hospital bills and insurance premiums for all of us.
All of the debt that hospitals take on has to be spread out somewhere so they can continue to provide care in their communities.
And in Wisconsin, addiction and Medicaid often go together.
Reimbursement we receive from Medicaid doesn't totally cover the cost of providing that care in our Wisconsin hospitals, so the hospital ends up taking that loss.
Many hospitals have repeat visits from abusers, and that can take a toll on morale.
Am I going to be able to do anything for this person? You know, maybe they've been back for two overdoses or three. We found people in our data that had been back and forth to the ER up to six times with an overdose.
Uncompensated care makes our medical expenses more painful. But there's another arena of opioid abuse that's costing us as well. Foster care.
Every case has some one or both of the biological parents' drugs.
Snyder says more than half of the children in foster care are there for that very reason, opioid abuse. And it's down the road where that becomes costly. Once these kids hit 18 and age out of the system, it costs taxpayers $300,000 per person.
One out of two end up in our jail system. One out of five are homeless. Many of them are on state assistance for years and years and years.
Course correcting this financial black hole won't happen overnight.
It doesn't necessarily lend itself to one simple solution. There are no simple solutions.
Senator Ron Johnson says the best way out of this hole is to help our troubled peers quit digging, and we all have to help.
There's just not going to be a pill. There's not a magic pill that cures an addiction. What it is, it's going to be long-term involvement by families and by the community.
It's a long-term commitment that families, communities, and our state have invested in to one day hopefully put an end to the opioid epidemic. John Domol, Local 5 News.